Hello, everyone out there. Today I'm going to show you my demonstration of this painting, which is a painting of a basic sunset here in Oregon on my nightly commute. First thing that I'm going to do is just do a quick sketch with this gris-green mixture that I have. It's actually just a mix of all the colors on my palette. Horizon sky color to be really bright. I think that's pretty clean. So a lot of basal white. It's looking good. Some of that Hansa yellow. Too much. God, that's a strong color. Okay, now those even lighter layers, I want them to be more greeny. This may be too yellow still, but let's see what it looks like. That's kind of cool, actually. So rather than just going lighter, I'm going to just shift and add some layers on top in the lightest areas of the clouds that are more yellow. Let's see what it does. Thank you.
needs to be connected. It's actually really useful to be able to see the painting on the camera. It's kind of like stepping away from the camera, taking a few steps back. Same effect, gives you an idea of how things are looking overall from a distance. Pale white green colors here. And these are just going to be kind of speckled. And I want that sense that they're originating from the lower left part of the canvas, or board in this case. I'm liking that. Okay, what to do about that patch of magenta, huh? To the base of the painting. That color is not too far off where I want it to be for the sunset, but I just made too little of it, so I'm gonna make a lot more. Probably do is carve out this tree with negative space a little bit after it's dried more, and also after I've switched to using a smaller brush. Looking at this in the reference photo, it's pretty dark, so I'm gonna paint that in. Remaining magenta space in with some darker green transition colors here. Just kind of come in and selectively add just some mixing on the painting using some brushwork. A little bit right now, a little bit too clumpy for me, like not quite enough lost edges, so I'm gonna come back and use my now cleanish brush to do that mixing, kind of like what we got here. Alright, I just took a step back and I really like how this is looking. I'm pretty psyched. So, see how I feel in a little bit after I've ruined it. But what I'm going to do now is switch away from this half inch, or what is this? Oh, it's all rubbed off. I think it's probably like half inch, number 7 or 8. Switch to a smaller brush. This is a number 2 round, nice and soft. I'm going to use this guy to add in even a few more highlights, brighter spots. And what I'm trying to do, or going to try to do, is alternate light and cool colors. So even, you know, what I mean by that is if, like, if we're in a background of a relatively warm background here, I'll try to add in some lighter but cooler greenish yellow on top. And not increasing the saturation much, but maybe increasing the value a little bit. Just to give a sense of depth to the clouds. Same thing here, it's kind of got that bluey cool background. Add a little bit of warmer color on top, and those features then pop out at you more. It just gives a sense of depth, like I was saying. Green base layer here, so not a bad way to do it with some purple. Add some texture. accentuating what's already there with a more contrasting, slightly darker color. So that's my goal. Too big of a magenta patch there. Umber is a warm color. I'm going to use some of that purple to darken it down. Stop and see, walk away from it for a little bit and then come back and take a look once it's a little less shiny and see how I feel about it. And maybe I'll continue painting and maybe I won't.
And here's the final painting once again. I like how it turned out. The only additional thing I did off camera was added a little bit of white down at the bottom to suggest the brightest part of the horizon line, and then I put it up on my wall, and we'll see how it ages. I'll let you know if I make any changes to it going forward. Thanks for watching. Don't forget, give me a like and a subscribe if you want to. Bye.